Hello guys, welcome to our channel Saraf Financial Info. So today we will talk about the Yes Bank. Is it in trouble again? Because you are seeing like share prices again on decline. So what is going in Yes Bank? We will discuss today. So the story is, when a bank needs money, it has a few options on the table. So it could borrow money by raising deposits from its customers. You know, the fixed deposit kind of thing. That's a traditional way to do it. It can also issue the bonds to the public. The bank will pay merchant on their bonds and it promise full repayment on the specific date. It's like a fixed deposit. You can remember in this way. And it could issue new shares to the investors, but it means that ownership gets diluted. And if the owners of the bank held 1 out of 100 shares before, now they might only have 1 out of 110 shares. And some people don't like the losing ownership. Now, in the case of fixed deposit and bonds, bank have to return the money at the end of the promised period. The money has limited shelf life, but equity money doesn't come with such strings attached. The banks get to keep the money basically forever. So some finance geeks sat around a table and thought, what if we could create something fabulous and combines the feature of the bonds and equity shares? Like in equity shares, nobody gets back money. They sell to others, but in bonds, after certain periods, they have to return. So they bring out something combination of these. So we could pay interest to the investors like a regular bond, but we get to keep the money forever like equity. So that's how perpetual bond were born. So banks loved it since they didn't have to return the money to their customers. So they could simply add it to their long-term capital buffer. It could shore up their reserves. They called it an additional tier 1 or AT1 bond, and it comes in a handy case of the emergency or a financial crisis. The bank can dip into its reserves and keep running smoothly. So all this was looking good so far. But anyway, the public premise, when someone invests in an FD or bond, is it they consider is like a safe, or like they won't going to lose that money? And the rule of the game say that if a company is failing, it sells all of the things, remaining assets and all, and pay to their lenders, and lenders being FD or either bond investors, and they get protection. On the other hand, an equity investors is treated differently. They are considered as a part owner. When the bank does well, they have the unlimited upside, and the share price can zoom and give them windfall, and they can earn dividends, unlike bond and FD folks who only gets a consistent interest rate. Even if the bank earns super normal profit, so if an equity investors get an outsized upside, it's only fair they take the hit on the downside also. So that means if a bank fails, they get wiped out, and no one's going to feel sorry for them and say, oh, you poor equity investors, so here is some money we got from the asset we sold. But here is the thing, the perpetual bond are the hybrid creation. They have got both debt and equity characteristics. They pay interest like regular bond. However, if the bank is struggling and on the brink of catastrophic failure, then it can ignore these perpetual bond investors. It need not to pay them back. It can write off its perpetual bonds and the investors get nothing. It's nada. It's nothing like a fixed deposit. Crazy, right? All that talk about bonds being safe gets thrown in the bin when it comes down to the business of the perpetual bonds. And this finally brings us to the Yes Banks. See, in 2020, the bank ran into trouble, March 22. People and corporate it lent money to were defaulting, bad loans were soaring up, and Yes Bank was on the brink of catastrophic failure. Everyone thought the bank would go belly up, but it peers stepped in and rescued it. SBI and 7 other Indian banks took a combined stake of 79% in Yes Bank. The bank even issued new equity shares at the massive discount and raised more money. FD holders were saved and bond investors were cocooned. Even equity shareholders were protected. But the one who invested in perpetual bonds, thinking they were as safe as houses, they got the short end of the stick. They lost everything. Over 8,000 crore worth of these perpetual bonds were wiped out completely. Naturally, many of these investors were livid, like they were unaware about that. Based on the bond words, they bought it because that bond will be safe. So they complained that Yes Bank's own staff members had sold them these perpetuals and they were fooled into believing that their investments were safe as FD. Yes, with FDs, the bank is expected to return the principal at the end of the term. With the perpetual bonds, they don't have to return the principal. However, the bank do extend a call options where they can redeem the bonds and return the principal at their discretion. So you could still sell these as an alternative to fixed deposit, or even better, rebrand and call them super fixed deposit. So which is apparently what some Yes Bank employees did back in the day. Eventually, though, the bank failed, the bond were written off and super fixed deposit just disappeared into the thin air. It wasn't super, it wasn't fixed. Needless to say, aggrieved customer took the matter to the court. And rather a bit of back and forth, this was the Bombay High Court said on the Friday. We are paraphrasing that the court said to make it simpler, okay. So the RBI put together a preliminary plan to save the bank. In the plan, it said that the bank was going to write off these perpetual bonds, but the people naturally raised the objections. So the RBI modified the plan and delete this clause. It submitted this new plan to the government. The government read it thoroughly and gave it the green light. That means the final plan did not say anything about writing off these perpetual bonds. So how could the person in charge of executing this plan randomly decided to write off these bonds? It's clearly lapse in the operating procedure. So the end result, Yes Bank might have to bring back the perpetual bonds from their graves. And that's getting a few other people worried. See, the bank was just beginning to look well. It was cleaned up its act and things were looking normal. But how this? So naturally, question on everyone's mind is, will the Yes Bank have to pay the investors the full 8,000 crores of the perpetual bonds? Well, maybe not, but we'll wait for that. But didn't the court just order that? Not really, because here is the thing. If you read the order, you'll find that the High Court isn't saying how perpetual bonds should typically be treated. Complete write-off, haircut, conversion into equity, that's not the question in hand. It's not even talking about the mis-selling the perpetual bonds. The court only said that at least in the case of Yes Bank, the final decision-making process to write off the bonds was flawed. That means Yes Bank could simply follow the order and bring these perpetual bonds back to the life, include the bond as a part of its capital, and then turn back and say, sure, we have brought these bonds back, but we are not going to pay any interest on these bonds. And we are also within our rights to keep the money with us forever, because the terms and conditions state that we are not obliged to pay anything if the banks fail, which is it did. And a few years ago, sorry, but that's just how these bank things work. So yeah, maybe the order won't really hurt Yes Bank. We'll keep the money and the perpetual bond holder will likely still be left holding the bags worth wondering what the future. It's a terrible situation for the poor customers who bought the perpetual bonds in the hope that these are FD, they are safe. It's a lesson for the customers run behind the good returns without knowing the full details. So thank you for watching it. Please like, share and subscribe.